really need, you know, push us. We really need someone to come stand with us so that we can be able to work out better. And
I think what Van Ponger is trying to say is that, you know, we've experienced about a 65% drop in support in this second year of COVID. It's almost inconceivable how low our income has been this year. And you know, there's been a lot of people respond to circumstances of this world in fear, not faith. And you know, we know that anytime gas prices alone, and of course gas prices push food prices up, and they push toilet paper up, they push all these things up, that people are squeezed for the dollar. And even our larger donors, we've received very few large donations this year, and even those donations are maybe a third the size that they used to be. So we really need some help. We need some help through God Loves Kids. As we get help through God Loves Kids, we can help Van Pong and work with the kids there. And you know, we're limited in what we can send by what we receive. You know, Bess and I and Mom have done just about everything we can do this year to make this ministry work and to make it possible. We did everything we could do last year, but we've come to kind of the end of the road, and we really need some help from our friends and our supporters before the end of the year to make up the difference of this shortfall, huge shortfall, an unimaginable shortfall. I don't think that any of us could have ever predicted that COVID would go way beyond the election into a control phase of the worldwide population. And so, you know, but regardless of what's going on in the world, there are still children who are starving, and there are still children who need education. And Jesus said directly that we are supposed to, as Christians, we have a moral obligation. We have a spiritual mandate from the Savior to take care of widows and orphans.